excited? Are you excited for a vlog? You know what? I literally just decided I need to get back on my YouTube game. You know, lately my videos have been very sparse. My Instagram is popping, but my YouTube is very sparse, and that's for many reasons. But I'm coming at you today. I didn't sleep last night, and that's because a lot of reasons in response to the job that I'm working. The security guard thing is just like one thing, things affect each other. And today's my last day working there. And so part of this whole vlog is we're going to Michael's, the arts and crafts store. And people are still driving crazy. And because it's Mercury retrograde shadow period, so still be careful. Michelle, why are you driving with one hand on the wheel and one hand filming? Mercury retrograde, girl. So I decided to change up my angle here. Is this better? I don't know. Probably not. So, I haven't told you guys this, but when I was a little girl, my favorite subject in school, in elementary school, was actually art. And we didn't have official art class. You know, in kindergarten, we do painting. I think even up till maybe second grade, you still do coloring, some kind of coloring. But after that, you really don't do much art class at school. And then in fifth grade, we kind of like, my school was like, kind of had this program where you, weird chalk oil crayon thing, and you get to smudge it with your fingers, and then we like drew our own like silhouettes, and then we glued it on top of our pastel drawing of Starry Night. It was just like, oh my god, I can't even explain to you guys how excited I was to work on that art project every other Friday. And so one Friday, my mom had to check me out early out of school because I had an orthodontist appointment. And it just so happened to be the final day that we were working on our Starry Night art project. And because I knew every other Friday, oh, we get to work on our, do art class, you know. And so, like, I totally had a meltdown, a classic Michelle meltdown. And, you know, as I've gotten older, these meltdowns have been fewer and far further between. Since working on my mental health, they haven't been as extreme. But I was just in tears and tears and tears, inconsolable. And my mom had no idea, you know, she didn't know. But I remember exactly what outfit I was wearing. And I would just remember crying in the dentist waiting room. And I never got, because it was the last day, you know, we weren't going to see that teacher again. And so I never got my Starry Night art project. And, middle school, high school, I was still into arts and crafts, you know. I would decorate my notebooks and decorate different things, try to make my own clothes. But I just never... Oh, and I kind of did draw a little bit, too. I kind of, lost touch with my visual, you know, creating arts thing. And that's something I've been wanting to get back into for a while. And then, you know, reading the Psychic Twins book, Psychic Intelligence, you know, they talk about looking at things in a different way, broadening your perspective, trying out different hobbies, getting into different kinds of arts, and to improve your clairvoyancy. And also too, because I'm a very creative person. Just, you know, that's one of my good qualities. And I have so much fun creating stuff. And lately, because of this freaking job I've been working, it's literally, you might be thinking I'm being dramatic, but this is how I really feel. I feel like my soul is being sucked out of me. It's like, honestly, whenever you do something you literally hate, oh, I can't remember if this is where you turn. But anytime you have to do something you hate, come on, girl, are you serious? Like, what kind of life is that? I think I should have turned the other way. I'm not sure. Especially, like for so long, and it's so far away. It's just like, honestly, I was doing the math in my head. Even though my shift says 7.5 hours, it's really a good 10 plus hours out of my day, because I gotta get ready, gotta drive over there, gotta drive home, you know? And in all reality, I'm only clocked in for maybe 6 to 7 hours, 6.5, 7 hours, because 30 minutes is taken out for my lunch, and sometimes I clock in late, sometimes I clock out early. $15 an hour is barely over minimum wage. Take out the taxes. Is it worth it, girl? No, it is not worth it. To have a fucked up sleeping pattern, to be spending all this money on eating out, to not be able to cook my own food, like so much time out of my day. I haven't been to jiu-jitsu at all this week. I haven't been to the gym at all this week. Like, how do people have fulfilling lives when they have to work a job like this, you know? And I know most people out there hate their jobs. Like, how do people do this? And then their sleeping pattern's all fucked up, and they eat fucked up and they feel fucked up and how does it get better? And a lot of people just think, oh, that's normal. That's just what you have to do. No. It's, number one, it's fucked up that it's normalized. And number two, it's not what you have to do. There's so many more things you could do. You know? This world is not limited. We are limitless. We really are. But anyways, so actually, you know, and I've been getting more into artists on Instagram. I've been following a lot of artists, like visual artists. And also too, like, you know, just, you know, meeting Sand. If you guys don't know about Sand One, meeting her and how inspiring she is. She's an artist. That's her passion. She's making a great living off of that. She's fulfilled by that. She's following her dreams. I paid one of my friends, she does more calligraphy, but I commissioned her to make a sign for me for when I do my crystal healing pop-ups. And I felt so, like, good paying an artist to do something for me. And yeah, I paid her $50. I went to her and I said, hey girl, this is what I want. I'm going to pay you $50. That's what I said. Okay? And I just thought, if I were in her place, if someone were to come to me and say, hey Michelle, I'm going to give you this money, can you make this for me? Whatever kind of art thing, I would be so happy to do that. And then I have another friend. It's like now more and more artists are coming up in my life. And then I have another friend who, she's a super cool, super, super cool Capricorn little white girl, such a hard worker. She goes to jiu-jitsu with me, and she, talk about Capricorn, hard working little white girl, okay? She started jiu-jitsu after me, like maybe a month or two after me. And there's other girls at jiu-jitsu, but she's the only girl that has leveled up, and basically all the exercises, like all the lessons, and all of us girls are just like, whoa. She's the smallest one too. She's the smallest one. Like, oh yeah. And we're just like all clapping for her, inspired by her. And that's what made me want to like work harder in jiu-jitsu too, which I was doing pretty good. But the thing is like I can't keep it consistent because of this freaking job, you know what I mean? But anyways, so she's an art teacher. And I asked her, I was like, hey, what supplies can you recommend to me? Because what I really want to get into, what's really speaking to me, is watercolors and also pastels. I'm going to recreate my Starry Night, girl. I am going to recreate it. And I'm gonna be so proud of my Starry Night. But, so she was like so happy that I'm going to get into, you know, making some visual art. And I actually went to Michael's, when was it, last Friday? After jiu-jitsu. But by the time I got to Michael's, they were already closed. And I have so many things on my shopping list. Like, I made a shopping list last night while I was working. Of, like, all these things I want to buy. Because I want to, you know, I've been clearing out my room. Like, I need to do a room tour. I'm super proud of my room. It's, like, way cleaner, way more organized. I threw away a whole bunch of trash. You know, I'm selling a whole bunch of my stuff. Like, I'm ready to let go of so much stuff that wasn't serving me, wasn't sparking joy. And I'm ready to embrace this new chapter in my life. This chapter in my life where I believe in myself. I have confidence in myself. You know, I'm healthy. I'm self-affirming. You know, I'm secure in myself. I'm creating my own path. You know, I'm living my best life. And so I made a list of all these things that that my heart's desire. You know, things I want to wear, things I want to decorate my room with, you know, body care stuff. Whoops. You know, stuff like that. And part of it was, you know, art supplies. And I'm trying to get out of this lack mentality because it's not serving me. And it's a hard place, honestly. It really, even though I'm saying it's a hard place, that's the part. I'm feeding the negative vibes. But I'm working my way. I'm working my way through it. And when I'm doing the work, when I'm making myself open to receive miracles, I feel like the universe is going to meet me halfway. And honestly, if not halfway, more than halfway, because the universe is amazing like that. And I'm about to go into Michael's, and let's go. Okay, girl, let's go, girl. Look at all these planner stickers. What have I been missing this whole time? I haven't been coming to Michael's. I want this one. I don't even know what you do with it, but I want it. It's so pretty. I honestly forgot why I came here. Go big or go home, am I right? I think I'm gonna get this one. My friend told me to get this one. Now, I need some paper. Some papier. Cool. I'm sure you can find this online though. Or just experiment. I look so. We're not gonna go there, Michelle. Not today. Watercolor. That one options? What if I get this one? Okay. They literally sell canvases here. I never realized. You see how out of touch I am with the art world? It's not okay. Okay, now we have to find pastels. If you were pastels, where would you be? Alright, friends, so I'll just do a little haul in the car. You guys basically saw already everything I got, but I picked up some extra things. And honestly, I'm not gonna lie, I was conflicted. I was like, should I get these things? You know, it's like, how can I talk about my current situation without feeding into the negative energy that the universe is listening? It's like, I'm going to Thailand in 3-4 days, alright? I mean, I don't know. I honestly, all the doubts, all the little things that were holding me back, I was like, you know what? I've been suppressing my artistic flow. How's it working for me? Not very well. And the fact that I got so excited walking through that store, like, I got so much inspiration, so many ideas, and it's like, I haven't been to Michael's in so long. And I mean, that arts and crafts is something that makes me so happy. I love doing that. I love making art. I love making stuff. And I'm good at it, you know? So it's like, why deny myself that? And I just, I forgot which video, who was saying this, but they were like saying, like, money is a resource. Oh, I know who she is, but I don't know what her channel name is. She's like this blonde lady, and she has an accent. She's like saying that, you know, we're only on Earth for a short amount of time. You know, our body is the vehicle of our spirit. And part of living on Earth is, you know, money's a part of it. But when we leave here, we don't take it with us. So it's like, just, you know, use it as we need to use it when we're on Earth, and don't attach more to it, you know? It's really hot, actually, because the sun is coming out. But anyway, let me show you what I got. I ended up signing up for the rewards. So I did get a discount, pretty good discount, and so I got a sketching pad, honestly, because I need more paper for my automatic writing, and I need something that's bigger to allow my arm more freedom, you know, of movement. And the Psychic Twins recommend a legal pad, but honestly, I feel like a legal pad. Don't they make legal pads where they're just plain white? Because I was just thinking of the yellow kind with the lines, and I thought that's not as pretty. And I thought this would be prettier, you know? Plus, I got some cool pens that will make my automatic writing look pretty. Plus, what if I just want to doodle, you know? And then I got two little journals. They had a lot of cute little journals. I chose a lot, but then I just decided on two, because they were $5 each. So I got this one that says, I need space. And then this one that says, random cosmic thoughts. And they're like lined journals, you know, with little ribbons. And because I want to get into journaling more again, because I used to do that too when I was younger. And then I got some toned tan paper for my pastels. I didn't realize this. You need a different kind of paper when you work with pastels. So I'm glad I asked my friend, my little Capricorn art teacher friend. So I'm excited to do that. I never used pastels on that kind of paper before. And then I just got like the cheapest paper for watercolors. And then I got, of course, the watercolor you saw me choose, the Praying. This is a 16 color one. And it was relatively inexpensive. Probably should have gotten just the 8 color one to save some money, but I wanted more options, you know? So, excited to do that. And then I got, for my, as my friend suggested, the Faber-Castell, soft pastels. I got the 24 pack, which I think it was like $19. You can't really see because of glare. But they had a larger pack and it was more expensive, but she told me just to get this one. It's pretty good for, you know, pretty good for the money, she said. So I'm excited to use those. And then like I mentioned, I got some cool pens, which if you guys were alive during the 90s, you guys remember the trend of gel pens. And I was so surprised, honestly. A few years ago when I was into scrapbooking, not a few years ago, like 10 years ago, when I was into scrapbooking in high school, I remember I came across gel pens and I was like, what the heck? They still make gel pens? So imagine my surprise when I see they still sell gel pens. You feel me? And it used to be a thing where you would like collect them and all that. So I got a whole bunch. There was more I wanted, but I limited myself and this is as much as I got. So I got 4 neon ones, and I actually just had an idea with these colors just last night, but I didn't have these colors, so it was like perfect timing. It's a neon green, yellow, pink, and orange. And then they had some sparkly ones, and I was drawn to the cooler colors. So it's like navy blue or midnight blue, purple, and just a regular blue. So these are sparkly. And then I got 2 metallic ones, and they're just metallic silver and metallic gold. I feel like I got a good selection, you know? Actually, I got all the colors of the rainbow, except for red, and I didn't get brown or black or white. But I pretty much got your basic colors, right? So that's great how it worked out. And then I got some stickers, because if you guys didn't know this about me, I freaking love stickers. I mean, come on, I used to be so into scrapbooking. I still have a whole bunch of my stickers from that time, and those are the stickers I've been using. If you guys see me post about my planner, those are the stickers I use in my planner. Plus, it came with stickers and all that too. But I haven't bought new stickers in such a long time. Well, and I did buy stickers when I used to teach kids. And I honestly, like, kept some for myself. But these were $2 each. And they had some really good stickers. Like, they upped their game so much. I was not aware of this. They have, and I feel like I'm talking weird. And that's partly because I didn't sleep. And partly because I'm thirsty. But anyways, so these stickers, I don't know if you guys can tell, but they're like crystals and constellations and stars. I was like, girl, crystals. crystals are becoming so, I mean, crystals already were mainstream already, but like they're becoming more normalized. But people, the thing is, people still don't know what crystal healing is. They have crystals, they're wearing, this is the funniest thing. Every time I go to these healing events, all the girls are covered in crystals. They're wearing more crystals than I am. Crystals, crystals, crystals. And then they're like, what's crystal healing? They're like, oh yeah, I'm gonna have a crystal face roller, you know, crystals in my water, crystal stickers. Yeah, let me buy some crystals. Yeah, but what's crystal healing? The last frontier, the final frontier is to find out, girl. Lay on my table and you will see. Anyways, and then I got these ones. These ones are like mermaids. And then is seahorses and dolphins and stuff. And they're all like pastel-y with some like holographic touches. And then these are unicorns with some rainbows and stars and moons and stuff. And then these are really pretty. It's a springtime one. So it has like flowers and butterflies. So I thought those would be so cute to add to my planner. And yeah, that is everything I got from Michael's today. I'm so excited to get started on my new little projects. And I mean, who knows, people? Maybe, you know, I'll sell some of my artwork, you know? I don't know. Who knows? I mean, who knew that I was an automatic writer? Who knows? Maybe I'm a really great watercolor painter. If anything, it's just for my own fun, you know? My own artistic release. But thanks so much for watching this video. I'll see you guys in my next one. Peace, and also, think differently.